Okay, the purpose of this Tanner 2 is to introduce your very first Access project, which is called the Best Tech Class Ever. So to do this, you'll need the handout, and then you're going to need to open up Access. So I'm going to go to All Programs, and I'm going to go to Microsoft Office, and I'm going to open up Access. I want to create a blank database, so I'm going to click on that. So this is what a blank database looks like when it opens up. I prefer to go to View, Design View, and I am going to name this Best Tech Class with my initials after it. I use my initials because I can't add a header or footer in Access. Okay. Now we do not want to have a primary key. I repeat, we do not want to have a primary key. Because if we do, then it's going to automatically put numbers in there for us, and we don't want that. So I'm going to click off of the primary key button, and that gets rid of that. What are the field names I need? I need last name, first name, age, birthday, grade, favorite color. Okay. So I'm going to go last name, first name, age, birthday, grade, favorite color, favorite music, and favorite candy. Okay, those are all my fields. Okay, these are data types. Last name is not a number field, it's text. Okay, look down here. This says you can add 255 letters for the last name. Do you think that's too long? I do, so I'm going to shorten it up. Now I'm going to go through and I'm going to change this text field to 25. And then I'm going to make the age a number. That way I can sort it, because you can't sort text chronologically. For the birthday, I'm going to use something a little bit different. I want to do date and time. So for my input mask, I'm going to click the ellipsis over here. That's the three dots. And I'm going to save the table. I'm going to use the short date format. And that's the way it's going to look. That's cool. That looks great. So I'm going to say finish. All right, grade, I also want to be a number so that I can sort it if I need to. And then text, favorite color, and favorite candy, I've changed all of those to 25. Now I'm going to go to view, and I'm going to save the table. I'm going to say yes. All right. And I've entered one person's data in there, Robert Johnson. Now you'll notice Robert's a little bit old for a freshman, but you'll notice the first name, you cannot read the whole field. Okay, so I'm going to double click. There you go. Now you can read the whole field name. Age is good. Birthday is good. Grade, you can't read the whole thing, so I'm going to double click. Favorite is good. Favorite music, I'm going to double click. Favorite candy, I'm going to double click. All right, now I just have to hit enter, and I can finish filling out my data sheet. This is called populating the data sheet, or inputting data. Okay, once you're done inputting the data into your data sheet, you can always run your spell checker on it. And remember, spelling does count. You should capitalize proper nouns. Double check, make sure you can read everything. We can't read that. Okay, that looks good. All right, we've input all of our data. Now we can look and see what we need to do with it. We need to print the entire database in alphabetical order. So we're going to click on last name, and we're going to sort it, and double check, make sure it's in alphabetical order. It is. Go File, go to Print Preview. All right, now you're going to notice it fits on two pages. We don't want that. So you're going to have to change it to landscape. Now it fits on one page. You've got your initials in the title. It's a go. Print it. You're good to go. Close print preview. Okay, the next thing you need to do is print the entire database, but sort by favorite candy in alphabetical order. All right, favorite candy, sort alphabetical order, and go through the printing process again. Okay. All right. Next thing you need to do is you need to create a query with the last name, first name, and birthday, sort it by the birthday in chronological order. All right, so now I need to create a query. So I go to create, and you always use your wizards, query wizard. Yes, I'm gonna save it. I want a simple query. All right, last name, first name, oops, didn't want that. Last name, first name, and birthday. Next, best tech class, we're gonna call it birthday. Birthday query with your initials after it. And finish. All right, now, are these in chronological order? No, they're not. So you go here, you go home, and you sort 93, 97, 98, 99. It's a thing of beauty. All right, and then you can close this query, see? And save it, yes. All right, it's saved. Now we're gonna go back to the sheet. We want a query with last name, first name, and age from oldest to youngest. All right, so we need to create another query. Simple query. Now we have to choose our table because we've got two here. We've got a table and a query, so we're going to choose that. Last name, first name, age. Next. Next. Best tech class. Age query. My initials after it so that Mrs. Tanner gives me credit for my work. And then I have to sort it from oldest to youngest. Nope. Yep. And then you have to print it. And then you're done. All right, now you can close this. It's closed. Yes, I want to save it. Now let me show you a little something, something. So if I go back to my data sheet, okay, remember these are field names. All these things are records, okay? And I could filter for fuchsia, right? Remember I told you I'd do that? Filter by selection. All right, that's fuchsia. But if I go to close it and I save it, now watch what happens when I open it up. Oh, look, they're all there. But see, it didn't open my fuchsia one. Now, what happens if I go to open up one of my queries? And my query is exactly how it should be. So I could set up a query for fuchsia and name it fuchsia query, and it would always open up the way I wanted it to open up. Well, guys, that's it for this edition of TannerTube. I hope you enjoyed yourselves. Always remember to check your work. Check your spelling. Make sure things make sense. Have a good day, and thanks for tuning in to TannerTube. Bye.